Hi, I'm Nathanael. I'm a certified Okta professional, and I've managed Okta tenants at a variety of organizations. Today's video will walk you through how to configure a network zone in Okta, how to block access to the network zone, as well as how to create exceptions for individual users. A good use case for this feature is blocking access to Okta from known high-risk countries, as well as creating exceptions for employees that are traveling to these countries but need access to work. For this exercise, you'll need to be an organizational admin or a super admin in Okta. There are two ways to block access from specific networks or countries. The first type is a complete block, which denies access from any network or country specified in the block zone. When a user attempts to access the URL of the Okta tenant from a blocked country, the user will receive an error and won't be able to see the login screen. The second type of block is tied to the authentication policy of the user. Users in blocked countries will be able to access the login page for the Okta tenant, but when attempting to log in from a blocked country, Okta will deny the login and block their access. For the second method, we could add an exception based on an Okta account. A good use case for this is if you have an employee that travels to a restricted country, but has an exception from the security department or HR to work from that country, you could temporarily allow their access by adding an exception in Okta. To begin, navigate to the login page of your Okta dashboard and head to your admin dashboard. On the left-hand column, select Security and Networks. To add a network block, select the Add Zone button and then select Dynamic Zone. I already have a zone configured, so let's take a look at it. You want to give your name a zone, such as restricted countries. Make sure that block access from IPs matching conditions listed in this zone is checked. And then under the Locations tab, select a country that you would like to block. You could get granular with these blocks by selecting states or regions from different countries, or you could add multiple countries in a specific block. Make sure to click Save when you're done. I will demonstrate how this block works now by setting my VPN to Italy and then attempting to log into this Okta tenant. When attempting to access my Okta tenant from a blocked location, as you could see, Okta is giving me an error page and not allowing me to access the login screen from a blocked country. As you can see, this first type of block is a complete network block, and it won't allow users to access the tenant from a blocked country. It won't even allow them to access the login page. I'll now demonstrate how to do the second type of block, which allows users to enter their login page, but it will still block them when they attempt to log in. To set up this block, go back to the network page and add a network zone. I'm going to reuse the network zone that I had by editing it. And the only change here is that you want to uncheck block access from IPs matching conditions listed in the zone. The next step is going to the authentication page. Please note that in Okta Classic, the setting is located under Authentication and Sign-On, but in Okta Identity Engine, it's located under the Global Sessions Policy tab, which you can't see in this video. Under the authentication policy, go to the default policy and add a rule. Give the rule a name, such as block access from restricted countries. Under the if user's IP is in zone, type in the name of the zone that you created. For my example, it's restricted countries. And then select then access is denied. So essentially what's happening here is we're setting that if a user's IP is within the zone of the restricted countries, their access is going to be denied. You could get really granular with these settings, but for the sake of this exercise, we're just going to set this up. Select Create Rule, and the zone is now blocked. As you can see, compared to the previous block, I'm able to access the login page. When I attempt to sign in, Okta will block me and say unable to sign in. This is because the authentication policy notices that I'm attempting to access Okta from a blocked location. When I attempt to sign in, the authentication policy will deny me, and I won't be able to sign into Okta. In order to create an exception for this policy and allow users to log in from a blocked countries, edit the rule, and under the Exclude Users tab, type in the name of the user that you would like to exclude from this policy. This will temporarily allow the users to log in from a blocked country, and they'll be able to access Okta until you remove them from this exclusion. When a user is added to the exception to this rule, they'll automatically bypass this rule and flow into the default policy rule. You could get really granular and add additional rules which require and have different settings, such as requiring MFA, reducing the session time limit, and other types of behaviors. This concludes today's tutorial on how to create a network zone block, as well as how to add exceptions to zones.